Can you see my screen?
Yes, you can.
Yeah, yes, you can.
Okay, so for this project, I was upsetting Brazil. That was my country of choice. So for a start, I imported all the libraries that I needed, as you can see here. And then I read my data, the Kiva loans and the MPI regions. And then I used the head to, sorry. Yeah, so I pulled the data, as you can see below, the Kiva data. And then I grouped by according to, I had not started at this point actually looking at Brazil. So I wanted to see, because you see the first question was, what is the country with the most loans? So since I was subsetting with Brazil, I wanted to see which number it was, because I believe this project had 87 countries. So Brazil took the number 64 when I pulled the data frame. And then I started subsetting my data. So the first question was, what country got the most loans? Does the number of times a country's reference relate to the quantity of loans it got? So for me, I interpreted country as sector since I was subsetting for Brazil. So so as you can see, Brazil didn't have much in terms of data, but these are the activities that were in the data, the sector, and also the users described. So in this case, since I was looking at country as a sector, you can see the sectors that actually topped the list in terms of taking the loans were retail, services, clothing, arts. You know, from the dot head, I pulled the first 10. So these are the sectors, basically. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Then I went ahead and fetched I did the dot columns just to look at the data itself. So to still answer the same questions, I group by region, then the loan amount, just to pull out the regions which actually took the most loans. So as you can see here, Diadema, Maua, Santo Andre, and Sao Paulo appeared the top four in the list. Then I plotted a bar plot. Mm-hmm. And the same regions actually show, reflect. Yeah. Then again, I did a value counts just to answer the same questions, the same question rather. And in this case, you can see like, you see, when I did the dot sum, Diadema actually was the topped the region in terms of the most loans. But when I did the value counts, as you can see here, Maua took more loans than Diadema. Mm-hmm. So I believe that answers the question. Yeah. Then again, I plotted a graph with the region with the most number of loans on the same. So now in relation to, I just did a markdown here, in relation to the most loan amounts, the Diadema is topping the list, but when it comes to the quantity, Maua takes the lead. So for question two, what sector got the most loans? Does the number of times a sector is referenced relate to the quantity of loans it got? So again, I group by sector loan amount. And here are the sectors that actually took the list, the retail, the services, the clothing, and the food. Then I plotted the sectors with the most loans to reflect the same. Then I would group by funded amount, because you cannot talk about the quantity of loans without looking at how much those sectors were funded. And as you can see in the graph, that reflects the same. And as you can see in this, I believe when I did the group by, when I pulled the sectors rather and the most funded loan amounts, the top sectors remain the same. The retail services, clothing, food. Yeah.
Yeah.
So again, I plotted the graph. I was just trying to use all the methods that were in class. That we were told rather. Yeah, so again, I did the markdown to answer the question. No, because the number of times a sector is referenced to does not relate to quantity of loans it got, to an extent that agriculture has more loan amounts than arts, yet arts has more number of times it took loans than agriculture. I hope after food, the other sector seems to exchange their positions with respect to the number of times the loans were taken. This is as per the observation done here
in the various graphs.
Yes. So
yeah,
for question,
that's good.
Yeah, question three. For the top sector, what activity had the highest amount of loans? What does that say about that activity? So again, I group by activity and the loan amount. So as you can see in the data frame, The activities that topped the list were clothing sales, beauty salon, cosmetic sales, and home product sales. Then I grouped by and plotted the same. And then the observation that I made was Brazil seems to have an interest in growing their commercial sector, meaning we can assume the rate of unemployment is low. Again, we can also assume most of the profit proceeds from the top activities with high loan amounts is channeled towards having the repayment of loans, meaning the employed masses earn little wages.
Yeah.
Yeah. So for question four, what region had the highest loan amount? Again, a group by region and the loan amount. So we can see here again, the top four regions, Diadema, Maua, Santo Andre, and Sao Paulo. And I plotted again, bar plot, reflect the same. So yeah, Diadema and Maua are the leading regions with the highest load amounts. then for question five, what were the differences in distribution time and posted time of the loans? How does that compare to repayment interval for the various loans? So this question actually experienced a challenge, but I believe Ernest will be able to correct me. So yeah, I called in the data and just to showcase the distribution time and the posted time. Wow, I can see my disbursed time. Well, okay. So this is what I did. Then I posted the disbursed time and the posted time, but I can plot the graph. I think I had a challenge with this question. Maybe, Ernest, you can advise how to about plotting the
the question was asking.
The question was asking. what were the differences in distribution time and posted time of the loans? How does that compare to the repayment interval?
Various loans. This was just to get, you were supposed to get the difference between the disbursed and I think posted time, yeah. You were supposed to get the difference in time. So I think that's what, that's what happens down here in the code. So the first part, just go down. Scroll. Scroll chini kabisa, where we have the plots.
Okay. Yeah. So.
Yeah.
So from this, I believe the repayment intervals in Brazil, in particular, were monthly. As you can see in this graph.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I believe this was it's the best I could do. Yeah, this is the observation that I made, that most of the sectors and the loan payment rather was monthly. Yeah.
Yeah, that's still okay. I'll send an email to answer that. Send a notebook. For the solution to question number 5.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you. So question 6 was, what does the loan amount look like for various payment interval in various sectors, in various activities? For this, I grouped the loan amounts and repayment interval and the sector and the activity. As you can see here, the agriculture, construction, food, in comparison to the activity, there's a bit of a change, but you can actually see the repayment intervals from the data frame. So here, I was trying to plot. So I came up with some variables. Forget about cell 33. And so here I used the matplotlib to plot the graph for the same repayment intervals with the loan. You can see it's a bit jumbled up, but you can see a lot of monthly payments from the different sectors based on the loan amount. Yeah, then I tried to plot a combined line plot, but the results were strange.
Okay. That's okay. Just have a look at it more deeply.
Hello.
Yeah,
sorry, there's been a power outage at my house.
Oh, yeah. So I was saying that I'll just have a look at it deeply. After the presentation.
Yeah. So for this question, I had a challenge plotting the line graph, and then question 7: what are the numbers between male and female recipients? Does that communicate anything? So I did a def gender underscore lead and came up with the functions. Then I did the gender lead, and as you can see in Brazil, the female gender definitely lead in terms of borrowing the loans as opposed to the male. So as you can see, the number of female recipients versus male stands at 186 and 98 respectively, meaning that the probability of a female recipient taking a loan is 0.655 and for the male is 0.3. So that means females in this in Brazil actually are taking up, are leading in terms of borrowing loans. Yeah. So yeah. Question number eight was what sector in Brazil got the highest loan? So as we could as you could see from the top, the retail sector got the highest loan. This one I didn't plot because it's self-explanatory from the top. What region in Brazil got the highest loans? Definitely it was Diadema got the highest loan. So after that, I just did a small project report just to summarize the same. So out of all the 87 countries, Brazil holds the 64th position amongst the countries with the most loans, which means Brazil is amongst the country with least loan amount. Remember this this project, we had 87 countries. So yeah, so the retail services, clothing and food are the leading sectors in Brazil with the most loan amounts. The health and transportation sectors came in last, as you saw in my graphs. This means that Brazil consumer demand has a strong economic rebound outlook. And then now, this is just based on the questions, yeah? On the nine questions. So the clothing, the sales, clothing sales, beauty salon, cosmetic sales, and home product sales are the activities with the highest loan amounts in Brazil. So from this, I depicted that Brazil's economy is somewhat stable, and they're investing in a more investment or business-oriented activities. So it means that they're not struggling with food security and development. And then also given the sectors, you could see they're investing in beauty and the cosmetics. I felt that the citizens are not entirely dependent on employment. So, and then also this informs us that the clothing and cosmetic sales have, perhaps the investors in these activities have to price their products higher so that they can realize profits enough to offset their loans. Then another observation was with Diadema topping the list, followed keenly by Maua, Santo Andre, and then San Paulo. These regions borrowed the highest loan amounts. So it means these are the regions that actually drive the economic force behind Brazil. Then there's no major difference between the distribution and posted time of the loan. However, there's a difference in the repayment interval where we saw that most of the loans are being repaid on a monthly basis. Then also in terms of the borrower agendas, we could see the female recipients are topping the list. And then the sector with the highest loan in Brazil is retail, while the region with the highest loans is Diadema. However, Maua borrowed more times. I think in one of the data frames we saw Maua actually borrowed more times, the Maua region. So Diadema and Maua are the main economic regions that the country depends on in terms of retail and services, which drive the economy of Brazil. Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, that's all nice. A good presentation. Anyone who has a question for Anne, you are open to ask before we continue on to the next presentation. Anyone with any question? Okay, there is none. Yeah, I think we can move on to the next presentation. That was a nice presentation.
Thank you.
Yeah. Especially the part where you summarized the findings that you got from the data analytics that you did. Yeah. So maybe we can have someone else.
Yeah, that's well done, Anne. I wanted to comment on that again, the very last analysis on the whole project. And I think your presentation skills are good. It was easy to follow your presentation, and well done.
Thank you. Ernest?
Yeah.
Okay. Just let the others presume. The questions on the visualization.
Hmm.
Are we also to?
Yeah, you can present them. But
okay, let's first wait for the others.